Hey, all right, everybody getting lined up. Let's take a look at the grid. Nick Sorensen and Jason Wahlberg all in the front row. Juho and Harry all in the second row. Newcomer Alexander and Scott Nalawi on the third row. Mike Marshall and Adam Barker on the fourth row. Simon Zirk and Mike Dulling rounding out the top 10. Gregorio Caridi and Neil Obrador, 11th and 12th. 13th is Seba and Maximilian Gunther in 14th. Martin Johnson, 15th. Ed Schiller in 16th. Matt Baer, 17th. Ronnie starting back in 18th. As the drivers start taking to the grid, they're lining up just a couple of turns from the start line. Alexander is Sluzerchik. I knew I had his name spelled somewhere and I wanted to make sure I got it right. All right, if you haven't done so already, hit like, hit share, hit follow, hit subscribe, hit all the buttons. And then get ready, because these first couple of laps, they're going to be extremely exciting. Ferrari's on the front row, then the Porsche of Juho, Harry in the Ferrari, a couple of BMWs of Alexander and Scott, Mike Marshall in a Porsche, and we have a few drivers that have not gridded. Ronnie did not get on the grid. Alexander did not get on the grid yet. Could we be seeing a couple drivers playing it safe by starting on pit road? Obviously, there are some tracks as they spend a lot of time jumping. Like I said, I grabbed the replay from practice and look for a video later today, probably tomorrow, but actually had some epic landings and some great jump skills. All right, everybody going down into the final turn. Porsche pace car dropping off. Through the final turn, and Nick Sorensen gonna lead him down. He is on the gas, green flag is in the air. And let's see how this first turn goes. The first turn and the first time up the mountain could be very interesting. No problems yet. Everybody, as mentioned, taking it a bit easy, and it looks like Ronnie is coming out on track. He went to pit road. I've not seen Alexander take the pit road. Now, here they come down the longest stretch and up the mountain they go. Any mistake here could be fatal for a lot of cars. That in between those walls, there is not a ton of space, and if somebody gets loose, spins out, it clogs up everybody behind them. So far, so good. Everybody makes it up the mountain. And now they have to go back down, and the speeds, the brake zones, everybody might be braking in different places. Things could get very sketchy going down the mountain as well. A very technical track. A lot of drivers said they'd rather run the Nürburgring than run here. And we did say earlier, if they make it through turn one, people start getting a bit overconfident, or lap one, excuse me. People will start getting a little overconfident. We could see some problems on lap two. Sorensen has already opened up a 1.2 second lead. He's got a little bit of a safety buffer there. Everybody pretty much single file down the long back straightaway. The field's spreading out pretty quickly here today. Down through the final set of corners, and Nick Sorensen will lead lap number one. They will have to make a single pit stop for fuel during this race. the track temperature is a lot cooler than we've seen the last 2 weeks, so these guys will have a little bit more. Oh, we've got a spin. Looks like Jason Wahlberg, not sure if he had any help on that one. Let's take a look. No, he snaps loose right in front of Yuho, manages to get it turned around though. And he is back out on track. Interesting to see him in the Ferrari today, as he has been in the Lamborghini the whole season. His eighth place qualifying for Adam, not too bad. If he if Adam Barker can continue to shake off some of the bad luck he's had recently and continue getting those podium finishes, he has a good shot at keeping his top 5 points position. And he has made numerous comebacks. Matt Baer has crashed. And coming up the mountain, let's see what happened. Oh, it looks like the car in front of him just got into the wall. Trying to see who that other car was. And Matt tried to react, didn't have enough room. Simon Zierk has crashed. And coming down the mountain, just gets in a little. Oh, and he gets a lot of help. Mike Dulling, and there are several cars involved. Mike Dulling has an incident coming down the mountain. You see the car getting squirrely there and just backs it into the wall. Manages to get towed off track before anybody catches up to him and has a problem. Looks like Simon Zierk might have had another incident. Let's double check. Yeah, he is in that outside wall going down the hill. This is after getting sent to the moon. Okay. That's funny. He's trying to drive on the wall. You usually only see that on a dirt track, but... All right, so after a couple of laps, obviously a lot of chaos early. Not as much as we expected, though, as Nick Sorensen is out front. Yuho has made his way to second, looking for the win here today to pick up a few points on that gap on Giancarlo. Giancarlo using a drop race today. So he has the opportunity, even with the drop race, Yuho has an opportunity to pick up some points here today. Harry in third, up really battling. And as we mentioned, the Ferrari seemed to be the best car here. Ferrari in first, Ferrari in third. Yuho did happen to say that the car, you can't back out of it any extra because it'll try and go around you. That Porsche really tries to bite you here. And several drivers saying that the Lamborghini is actively trying to wreck itself or kill you, one of the two. Maximilian Gunther has made his way up 5 spots. He is up to 9th. Let's take a look at where everybody's at after just 3 laps. Nick Sorensen in the lead. Yuho has 2nd place. Harry is up to 3rd. Scott Nalawi now up into 4th. Mike Marshall in 5th, Adam Barker up to 6th. Seba in the Mercedes, and a big surprise to even see any Mercedes on track today. A lot of these guys were saying the Mercedes is probably the worst car to drive here, but Seba's made his way from 13th to 7th. Neil Obrador in 8th, Maximilian has made it up to 9th place, and Martin Johnson in 10th. Look at Ronnie, who started from pit road in the Ferrari, up from 18th to 11th. Ed Schiller up to 12th now. Jason Wahlberg, after an early incident, back in 13th. Gregorio Caridi is 14th, after driving under a BMW. Matt Baer, the other Mercedes in the field, in 15th. Mike Dulling, after going to pit road and getting that car repaired, up back in 16th. Simon Zirk, currently in 17th after flying a BMW. And David, you're absolutely right. Anything can happen here at any time. As mentioned in the pre-race, I think this is really one of the tracks that is love or hate, and a lot of these guys really don't like this track. Haven't confirmed, but I heard Giancarlo doesn't like this track at all. That's why he is not here. He only got a few laps of practice in this week and just said no. He had the drop race available. You kind of don't blame the guy. Harry is staying with Yuo all the way around the track, but Yuo is now 4 seconds behind the leader. Scott Nalawi starting to close in, and look, Mike Marshall is back there, but Adam Barker right on Marshall's back bumper. Can Adam shake all the bad luck? Could today be his day? He's had some great pit stops lately that have helped him pick up a lot of positions. If he has a good pit stop that can close that 9 second gap to the lead, could we see Adam Barker get his first win of the season? Or will Yuho get win number 4? Or could Nick Sorensen run away with this and be the first driver other than Giancarlo and Yuho to win this season? 9 races so far this season, and Giancarlo has won 6, Yuho has won 3. Yuho in second, 4.5 seconds back. He's actually losing ground to Nick Sorensen. He is starting to pull away just a little bit from Harry. Scott Nalawi in 4th place. Mike Marshall in 5th. Still has Adam Barker right behind him. Oh, Marshall goes around, he clips Barker. Both of them into the wall. Mike Marshall has to tow to pit road. We'll see if Barker did as well. There you see just a little too much speed and a little net code there as he bumps into Adam Barker. Let's see how Adam Barker fared. Yeah, that was a huge netcode bump, and Adam Barker, a lot of damage to the BMW, to the front end, but and the right front, and it gets sketchy again as Seba catches up to him, and down the mountain they go, and Adam Barker was really struggling to get that car down the mountain. Let's go back and see where Adam is at this point. Obviously, the bad luck has returned Adam Barker on pit road. What a heartbreak after 2 really good races. Simon Zirk is on pit road. Seba is on pit road. A lot of guys coming down for repairs. And Nick Sorensen out front, Yuho in second, Harry in third, Scott Nalawi in fourth, Neil Obrador in fifth, Maximilian now up to sixth place, and look at this, the man on the move, Ronnie Wimberly up to seventh place after starting in 18th. Thank you for that update on Giancarlo. Oh my goodness. Nick Sorensen's lead still at 4.5 seconds, but Yuho has started to chop away at it just a little bit here and there. Harry in third is still 1.6 seconds back. Scott Nalawi 1.7 seconds back. Now with several cars that were between them gone, Neil Oberdorf in fifth is 14 seconds back. But Maximilian Gunther continues marching forward, and look at the run Ronnie is having. Not the fastest laps out there, but definitely the most consistent, keeping that car out of trouble. He has continued to march his way forward. And he is 4.6 seconds behind Maximilian, and he is gaining on him. Last time by, Ronnie was 3 seconds faster. I believe Maximilian was having to avoid the chaos in front of him. Ronnie did not. And Nick Sorensen is holding Juho at 4.5 seconds right now. Seba is back out on track. Dulling back out on track. Mike Marshall back out on track. Adam Barker back out on track. Seba 13th. Mike Dulling 14th. Mike Marshall is in 15th. And Adam Barker in 16th. Now the question is, how much ground can Adam Barker make up? That has been his specialty all season long, is recovering from these type of incidents. David, we have talked about the bad luck for Adam Barker this season, and that netcode was definitely some. Harry has been involved in an accident. Harry, who is making his way forward, hanging on to third, he just misses the turn. Let's see if we can get that from another angle, see a little bit more of it. It looks like Maximilian might have gotten caught as well. Looks, oh, he lost the back end just a little bit. Max it up into the wall. Let's see if Harry had already gone to the pit by the time Maximilian had gotten there. Let's see what happened to Maximilian. Such a heartbreak for some of these guys that really were moving their way forward. Coming down the hill, just losing the back end. And Ronnie sneaks by. A lot of drivers coming down the hill and managing to keep that car going. Scott Nalawi has come to pit road. This is a bit early for a fuel stop. Nick Sorensen now still has the lead. 4.7 seconds. He's extended it over Juho. Neil Oberdorf in third. Jason Wahlberg in fourth place now. Martin Johnson fifth. Ed Schiller in sixth. Ronnie has come to pit road. I'm thinking they might actually be able to go the distance from here. Scott Nalawi on pit road, Ronnie on pit road. I am surprised to see so many guys on pit road already. They should be able to make this on a single stop. You have to wonder about some of the strategy here. Ronnie was making his way up through the field extremely quickly. He is now back into 10th place, but he'll make up ground all when the others pit. Let's see if with these early stops, maybe we see Sorensen, Juho, and Oberdorf stop early. I have to agree with you, David. That Adam just having the worst luck this season. And early in the race and during practice, it looked like he had a fast hot rod here today. I thought for sure he was going to get another podium just based on the way he was running today. Not out of it yet. 45 minutes left to go. Anything can happen, but getting sent back, he is now in 16th place, 1 minute 41 seconds behind. Neil Obrador was just involved in an incident. Coming down into the final turn and gets a little wide, catches a little bit of the grass right at the start-finish line. Should be minimal damage to Neil's car, though. Let's see if we can get a look at it. He's staying out. Looks like he might have some left front damage and a little bit on the right front, but not terribly bad. Mostly aero. And not even that much aero damage, to be honest. Oh, a little squirrely into the second turn. He has come to a stop. Something must have been worse on that car than we realized. Nick Sorensen's lead is now 6 seconds over Juho. Jason Wahlberg is now up to third. Martin Johnson up to fourth. And Ed Schiller up to fifth. Scott Malawi is sixth. Max Millian up to seventh now. Gregorio Caridi eighth. Ronnie starting to make his way forward again in ninth. And you can tell by these lap times, some of these guys are definitely playing it a bit safer than what we saw in practice. Some of the practice lap times were as low as 202, 203, but the fastest lap so far was Nick Sorensen, a 203.89. Everybody playing it very safe early in the going. Matt Baer has made it up to 10th. He was in an early incident. At this track, at any moment, the whole thing could change. Ed Schiller coming down. Scott Nalawi not far behind him in sixth place. Let's do a lap with Scott. As he comes down into the final turn. Oh, he saves it. What a save by Scott Nalawi. Looked like a little too much rear brake, and he got on it a little too hard. Down through the first turn, hard left-hander. Now down the long straightaway. This is where power and aero really pay off. Simon Zirik has crashed. We'll look at him here in just a moment. Coming down and into the right-hander to start your way up the mountain. Little left-hand kink here and then into the big left-hander. Second gear, third gear, back up the mountain, trying to accelerate as much as possible. It looks like Scott's actually gaining on him coming up the mountain. And you can tell the car is just never really planted. It's never really stable. You're fighting. You're having to move your hands the entire time. Now on the brakes, start back down the mountain. And a little smoke in front of him. Scott checks up just a little bit extra, making sure he can react. Nothing happening, but some hard braking up ahead. Now down at the bottom of the mountain, hard left-hander, and back on to the next long straightaway. And he has closed up enough, he might be picking up just a little bit of draft, especially with them going too wide, as Ed Schiller making a move. Ed Schiller now to fourth. Setting up for the right-hand kink, full throttle, and then on the brakes into the left-hander. Trying to get back on the throttle, build up speed through the short right-hand turn, then down to the final left-hand 90-degree turn. No incident, no problem for Scott Nalawi that time, and he gained a ton of ground on that lap. Let's see what happened to Simon Zirik. Simon is, I think he might have picked up some of Adam Barker's luck here today. Oh, just overshot the turn, gets into that outside wall. Tows it to pit road. Ed Schiller's having one heck of a run today. He is already up into fourth. Nick Sorensen's lead still right around 6 seconds. Yuho in second place. Jason Wahlberg in third, 35 seconds back from them. Ed Schiller in fourth, 6.6 seconds back from Jason. Martin Johnson right on his tail, and here comes Nololi. Back down the mountain, and this is where Nololi was faster than these two through that last lap, up the mountain and down the mountain. Gregorio Caridi, haven't talked about him much. He got caught in that early incident, ended up driving under Simon Zierk. He went and got repairs done. And is back out on track, currently running in sixth place, making his way forward. Maximilian Gunther in eighth. Matt Baer, one of the two Mercedes in the field. Actually, the Mercedes are, ninth and tenth. Matt Baer in ninth, Seba in tenth. Mike Dulling in 11th. Mike Marshall is 12th. Harry is 13th. Adam Barker has made his way up to 14th now. Neil Obrador has recovered from his incident up to 15th. Ronnie has fallen all the way back to 16th. I did not see where he was involved. He had an off track just a few moments ago. Coming down to the final turn. Oh, he clipped too much of the grass. Manages to get on the brakes, but backs it just a little bit into that outside wall. That's how Ronnie lost so much time after having a hard charge. Martin Johnson is coming to pit road. Should be within his pit window. Yuho back there in second, trying to make up some ground and some points here today. Jason Wahlberg in third, continuing his march forward, but still he is losing ground to the top two, but he is making up ground as Scott Mulawy just passed Ed Schiller and took fourth place. When we rode along with Scott, he was in sixth place. He has managed to pick up two spots in a lap. Now the question is, can he catch up to Jason Wahlberg, and does he have enough time? Probably not enough time to make up a 45 second gap to Yuho, but definitely has enough time to catch up to Jason Wahlberg. Interesting note today, as we mentioned in pre-race, a different complexion of the cars on track, as you've got six Ferraris on the track and five BMWs, only three Porsches, only two Lambos, and obviously only two Mercedes on track. A bit different when a lot of recent races have looked like a Porsche owner's club. And no McLaren in the field today either. Did not hear anybody even mention having tested the McLaren for this week. Ed Schiller has had an incident. He is on pit road. Let's see what happened. Oh! Let's back that up just a hair and find out what happened. It looks like he lost it. Coming through that turn, just goes too wide, gets in the grass, hits that outside wall, manages to keep it out of the way. A hard hit, and that car has severe damage. Scott Nololi, 10 seconds behind Jason Wahlberg. Gregorio Caridi, his recovery has been extremely impressive. He is now up to sixth place. Gregorio's in fifth. Matt Baer is now in sixth. Seba is in seventh. All of these drivers will have to make one stop at some point. Martin Johnson is the highest running car that has made his fuel stop. He is currently running in eighth. Although Scott Nalawi stopped on lap 7, he was one of those drivers that stopped with 45 minutes to go. And the question becomes, can he go the distance from here on fuel? Because the three cars in front of him have not been on pit road at all today. Whereas everybody else has been down for either repairs, fuel, whatever the case may be. Nick Sorensen has probably ran the most consistent race of anybody out there. He managed to get a huge jump on that first lap and has just continued to extend it. He was one of the fastest in practice as well. Qualified on the pole and has led every lap so far. Could make up a lot of points. Could see him get into the top 10 in points here today. Juho in second, looking to make up some points on Giancarlo, with Giancarlo not being in the race. Jason Wahlberg in third place, having one heck of a run. He has kept that car clean. And Scott Nalawi, he has already closed a second down on Jason Wahlberg. That gap now down to 9 seconds. Ed Schiller has been to pit road. Adam Barker has made his fuel stop. Maximilian Gunther has made his fuel stop. Actually, Ed Schiller came in after his incident, but made it his fuel stop as well. Adam Barker now up to 14th, working his way toward Neil Obrador in 13th. And the race, as we pass the halfway point, the race is far from over, as we have seen almost every position outside the top three has changed at some point due to an incident. There is no telling what could happen when you come to Bathurst. Here comes Jason Wahlberg up the mountain. First time we've seen him in the Ferrari this season. He is usually in the Lambo. Right on the edge of the rumble strips as he is sending it down the mountain. This track, 3.86 miles long, 23 turns. Most of those turns are as you go up and down the mountain. So you have the elevation change and the steep grades. There is one that's... I believe it was 16-1 grade up as you go up the mountain. 571 feet of elevation change. None of the top three have been to pit road. There's a big question mark about guys like Scott Nalawi, who stopped on pit road at 45 minutes to go. Can they go the distance? If he can, when the top three get to pit road, he'll pick up some positions. Adam Barker back on pit road. He is coming back out. And it looks like it might have been a repair stop. He had gone off track a lap before. Let's see what happened to Adam Barker here. As he comes through, looks like the final section of the track. Gets on the throttle just a little too wide. Didn't get any damage. Not sure why he came down pit road. He did have a little bit on the right front from an earlier incident, though. Nick Sorensen has dominated this race. You know he is one of those guys that's in the I love this track camp. He continues his march forward. Juho in second, Wahlberg in third, and Nalawi in fourth has closed that gap down to under 8 seconds from him to Jason Wahlberg. Juho is the first of the leaders to come to pit road. This will be his one and only stop. How many more laps will Nick Sorensen push it? Remember, this track, extremely long, 3.86 miles. If you run out of fuel, that is one long tow back to pit road. So these guys are not going to try and stretch the fuel to its absolute limit. Jason Wahlberg does not come to pit road this time. Sorensen starting up the mountain. Jason Wahlberg about to assume second, but Juho is on his way off pit road. It's going to be a drag race for second place here. Juho gets out in front of him. Wahlberg still has to stop. And Scott Nalawi closing in on both of them. Fastest lap last time was driven by Scott Nalawi. As he goes up the mountain, his gap now under 6 seconds to Jason Wahlberg. Based on lap times, if Scott can stay out the remainder of the race, he would catch and pass Jason when Jason hit pit road, and he could still catch up. He is only 6.3 seconds behind Juho. As the leader, Nick Sorensen, is on pit road. Second place, Juho, is just now starting down the mountain. Sorensen should be able to get off pit road before Juho gets there. We'll see for sure here in a moment. And I would expect Jason Wahlberg to hit pit road this time. I don't think he's going to try and stretch it too far. Through the kink, headed down into the left-hander, the final set of turns, will he come to pit road? 24 minutes remain. And Wahlberg is giving up third place to come to pit road. Meanwhile, Nick Sorensen is on his way off pit road as Juho comes down the front stretch. Sorensen is off pit road, maintains a decent lead right now. We'll see once it settles out. Wahlberg is on pit road. Nalawi has taken third. Nalawi now 6.4 seconds behind Juho. Nick Sorensen's lead now 7.2 seconds. He lost a little bit of ground on pit road. Gregorio Caridi now gives up fifth place. He is on pit road. Matt Baer is on pit road from sixth. Seba almost misses pit road. He's coming in seventh. And we've got a car off. I believe that was Ronnie Wimberly. Oh, just catches a little bit of the grass, backs across, gets into the sand though, manages to save him, and then just a few moments later, as he's coming out of the... There he is recovering, a lot of cars coming, and he has to get evasive. A really tense situation there for a lot of drivers. Sorensen's lead now down to 7 seconds as Juho has really cranked it up. Scott Nalawi in third is trying to gain on both of these drivers. Wahlberg back in fourth, 37.2 seconds back. Gregorio Caridi in fifth. Harry is in sixth. Mike Marshall seventh. Martin Johnson up to eighth. Maximilian Gunther in ninth, Matt Baer in 10th, Seba in 11th, Neil Obrador in 12th, Mike Dulling is 3rd, Ed Schiller is 14th, Adam Barker in 15th, and Ronnie back in 16th. Ronnie had such a good run early in the race, but it's just kind of gone away from him the last part of the last half of this race. Nick Sorensen currently maintaining that 7 second lead over Juho. Gregorio Caridi has started in 11th and has made his way up to 5th. One of the biggest movers so far. The other one, a bit of a surprise, Matt Baer started 17th up into 10th place right now. And he's bringing the other Mercedes of Seba with him. There was not much expected from either of these Mercs today. And yet, they are working their way into the top 10. Mike Marshall is on pit road. That should give Matt Baer 9th and Seba 10th place. So both Mercs now in the top 10. Scott Nalawi starting to close in on Juho again. Jason Wahlberg in fourth. Too big of a gap to overcome in 20 minutes unless there's an incident in front of him. And Nick Sorensen starting to pull away from Juho again. Scott Nalawi comes to pit road. He could not go the distance. Now, will he be able to hold on to a podium finish here? Jason Wahlberg, currently in fourth, is coming down the long back straightaway into the final section of turns. Nalawi still making his way. He just hit his pit box. As Wahlberg comes down toward the final turn. Could we see another drag race off of pit road here? Scott Nalawi's on his way off pit road. Jason Wahlberg coming down the front straightaway. Nalawi coming up to speed now. Wahlberg coming through the first turn. It looks like Nalawi is going to hold on to that top three spot. Looking through pit stop times, just by virtue of, I guess, that earlier stop, he got some fuel while he was in pit road. He is actually... had one of the shortest pit stops, in fact, the shortest pit stop of anybody in the field. But now, Nick Sorensen and second place Yuho may be out of reach as he is, Scott Malawi is 35 seconds back in third. Jason Wahlberg in fourth, 8.3 seconds. Neil Oberdorf heads to pit road for his final stop. And Seba has gotten around Matt Baer for ninth, moving Matt Baer back to 10th. Adam Barker still trying to recover, not making up any ground here since that early netcode incident. Nick Sorensen out front has extended his lead to 8 seconds over Yuho. Scott Nalawi in third was gaining on both of them, but he does not have enough time to make up that 35-second gap. Jason Wahlberg in fourth, Gregorio Caridi in fifth. And most of the field really starting to spread out. Not a lot of battles left to go. Martin Johnson in sixth, Maximilian Gunther in seventh. They are 3.8 seconds apart. Seba in eighth place is 6 seconds back. He might be able to catch up. Matt Baer in 10th, 4.7 seconds back. 11th place, Mike Dulling is 16 seconds behind, but Mike Marshall is on the back bumper. Neil Oberdorf, another 25 seconds back in 12th. Ed Schiller, not far behind in 13th. Ed was having a really good run earlier until an incident took him out of contention. Matt Baer is coming to pit road. Worth noting, we talked to Maximilian before the race, and his thing is just being consistent. He is not always the fastest, but he is one of the most consistent and continues to march his way up the points here in the last couple of races just due to that consistency. He is currently 3 points behind Adam Barker. I think after this race, he will have made that up, and he might move up into fourth in points here today. Scott Nalawi coming into today third in points, currently running third. Yuho second in points, currently running second. Nick Sorensen outside the top 10 in points, but that might change after this one. As Sorensen makes his way back up the mountain. Nick Sorensen has had the smoothest run of the day. Let's hop in the car with him as he is about to start catching lap traffic. He has not had to deal with very much lap traffic just due to pit stops and a little bit of strategy, but now I believe that is Matt Baer directly ahead. That is Matt Baer directly ahead, so lap traffic is about to become an issue. Once he passes Matt Baer, only 10 cars will remain on the lead lap. And that has looked like the most planted car all day long. We've seen several cars that were fast, but very, very squirrely and unstable. For whatever reason, Nick Sorensen has that car just dialed in perfectly and planted, sticking to the ground. Down through the first turn and gaining ground very, very quickly on Matt Baer. But the Mercedes power on the straightaway, definitely paying off there. But as they go up this mountain, watch how quickly he gains on him. The Ferrari, the most stable and nimble at the same time for this track. And you see a little bit of tire smoke off the car of Matt Baer. When we rode along with Scott Nalawi coming through here earlier, that car was he was fighting that car all the way around. Nick Sorensen just not bothered. Car seems to be so much more planted than everybody else. Back down the mountain, Sorensen goes. And look at how quickly he picks up ground on the Mercedes. But the Mercedes power really shows up on these long straightaways. But once you get into the corner, it really does not like turning all these sharp, short turns. Nick Sorensen out front. He'll have about six more laps to go. Juho in second, 7.8 seconds back. Scott Nalawi in third, 35 seconds back. Wahlberg in fourth, another 9 seconds back. And Caridi in fifth, 26 seconds back. Martin Johnson and Maximilian Gunther seem to be about the closest battle on track right now, looking through the field. No, Mike Dulling and Mike Marshall. Are extremely close as well. So only a couple of battles going on track right now. And it looks like Harry has crashed again. And a hard hit into that inside wall coming down the hill. Ronnie has had another incident as well. Ronnie had a great start to the race, but it has not turned out the way he wanted. And it's always been through this section. Is he trying to make the jump? No, he's going to make it regardless, and he makes it straight into the wall and blows the engine. It was a good jump, though. So Ronnie is towed to pit road. We'll see if he can get back out. Interesting, Nick Sorensen has not passed Matt Baer yet. I know the Merc power is definitely paying off on those straightaways, but I'm really surprised he hasn't been able to catch and get around him up the mountain or back down. Juho just continuing to run consistent laps. He knows he's got the second place finish in the bag. Scott Nalawi in third, one of the fastest drivers throughout the day today, has picked up a ton of spots. Had to pit early on, or he would probably be in contention for the win here. Doesn't look like he is pushing as hard now as he was earlier in the race. Just trying to keep it steady till the end. David, you're probably right. Plus, going down the straightaway, having that big, powerful Merc right in front of you, yeah, that can't hurt either. And now he's got the Merc in front of him, right in front of him, so he'll be able to stay in the direct. No, he's going to go for it. Just had to wait for the perfect setup, apparently, down to the kink. Looks like, yeah, he is going to clear him right before they get there. Matt Baer backing off a little bit early to play it safe. And Nick Sorensen gets around him and leaves 10 cars on the lead lap. Mike Marshall is the last car on the lead lap. And there comes Sorensen back behind him. I don't think Sorensen will catch him. I don't think he really wants to at this point. And Juho, there he is, 7.7 seconds back from the leader. Ed Schiller has had a little bit of an off. Oh, just didn't cut the corner enough. Scott Nalawi goes by. Schiller back on track. Bit of a heartbreak for Schiller. He was really consistently moving forward here today until he overshot going down the hill and wrecked the car. Had to tow to pit road. Mike Marshall has crashed. Oh, down through the turn just a little too fast. Loses the back end. And ends up towing it to pit road. That moves Matt Baer back into the top 10. So both of the Mercedes are in the top 10. Comes as a bit of a surprise, I think, to everybody. Seba currently in 8th, Matt Baer currently in 10th. And look at this. Adam Barker now up to 12th. And he is 9.8 seconds behind Neil Obrador in 11th place. So he is actually starting to pick up some time on the cars in front of him. 5 minutes left, probably not going to be enough, but you never know. Adam Barker is really good at making a comeback. Looks like several drivers might be done for the day. Ronnie's still on pit road. Simon Zierk is out. Mike Marshall appears to be out. Alexander has come back out on track. He came back out quite a bit later. And is 3 laps down. Harry is still in it. Ed Schiller's still in it. Adam Barker still. So. Quite a few drivers out of the event early. Not surprised to see some drivers not survive here at Bathurst. And Matt Baer has crashed. Let's see what happened to the Mercedes going down the mountain. Got on the brakes on the rumble strip and it just sent the car around hard into the outside wall. Matt Baer had worked his way back up into the top 10. Surprised to see the Mercedes up there, but didn't work out in his favor tonight. And that moves Adam Barker now up to 11th place. Adam Barker has closed down the gap to 8.25 seconds to Neil Oberdorf. But 3 minutes left. He is going to need a miracle here to catch him and get into the top 10. Meanwhile, Nick Sorensen, this lap, he'll get the white flag next time by. He'll have one more lap to go. Sorensen has just dominated all day long. From the drop of the green all the way through, nobody has touched him. He has driven it perfectly, no mistakes. Juho also extremely consistent today, despite a lot of guys, including Juho, saying the Porsche was very tricky to drive here. He has still maintained second place, and Harry has crashed. Going down, hitting the first right-hander, gets too much of the rumble strip and goes around as he tries to make his way up the mountain. Adam Barker comes by just barely. That was a little bit close. So it is Ferrari, Porsche, BMW, Ferrari right now in the top five. The top running Lamborghini is Martin Johnson in sixth. And Seba in the Mercedes is in eighth. Adam Barker, due to avoiding that incident, lost some ground to Neil Oberdorf, now 11.4 seconds back. And this should be the final lap for Nick Sorensen. He's led every single lap here today. Dominating performance. Juho in second has been consistent and just stayed out of trouble. Scott Nalawi, up and down kind of day, but being one of the fastest on the track, has made his way up to third. Jason Wahlberg, for the first time this season in the Ferrari, has made his way up to fourth, usually in the Lambo. Gregorio Caridi, one of his best races so far this season, up into fifth. Martin Johnson started back in 15th, has made his way up to 6th place. And Maximilian in 7th, this battle may not be over yet, and Seba right behind him. Nick Sorensen coming down the mountain. Meanwhile, these three will have one more lap to settle it. Thank you, Tessa. All right, one more lap for this battle. This is the battle for 6th, 7th, and 8th as Seba is back there. Meanwhile, Nick Sorensen is coming around, should be getting the checkers. Checkered flag is out. Neil Oberdorf just crashed. We'll take a look at that here in just a second as Nick Sorensen pulls off the win. Seba had an off track. Sorensen crashed. Let's see what happened first with Oberdorf. There he loses it coming down the mountain. Will that give Adam Barker the top 10? They're going to race into the checkered flag, but it will not be enough. Adam Barker comes home 11th. Sorensen wins. Juho finishes second. Scott Nalawi is in third. Jason Wahlberg fourth. Gregorio Caridi is fifth. Martin Johnson, Maximilian Gunther, Seba, Mike Dulling, and Neil Oberdorf rounding out the top 10. Let's see if we can get a hold of Nalawi first. Hey, Scott, this is Doug. You got me?
I got you, Doug.
Hey, I have to ask, what was with the stop about 15 minutes into the race?
Oh, I just had some damage from the walls.
Gotcha.
Well, yeah, I got damage on the first lap and then again avoiding someone, so I just had to come in.
Well, it looked like had that stop not happened, you had one of the cars to beat out there. You had some of the fastest laps, definitely some of the most consistent.
Yeah, I was feeling pretty good. Kind of disappointed with that one.
Well, you shouldn't be too disappointed. A third place finish, given the way the race went today, I'd be pretty happy with that, man. You survived.
Yeah, thanks very much.
All right, buddy. Congrats.
Thanks, man. Have a good one.
All right, let's see if we can get a hold of Juho. Hey, Juho, it's Doug. You got me?
Hey, Doug. How you doing?
Hey, I am good. Great run today, and I know you were saying in practice that the Porsche is just constantly trying to bite you here.
Yeah, and it still it does. You know, you should see my ass. It's full of markers, you know, red ones. Not nice.
Well, you managed to hold on to it. You had a few incidents, and it looked a little sketchy, but for the most part, you made it look really, really easy for the Porsche.
Yeah, but that was the fastest I can go, so congratulations to Nick. Really, really cool run, and he was so much faster than I was. But that was absolutely the fastest I can do with Porsche here. So,
well, man, it looked great. Obviously, with Giancarlo taking a drop race, you should pick up a few points today, and who knows what could happen the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, let's see. So, sorry he wasn't here. It would be nice to have a race there. It was a bit of a lonely one this time.
Well, regardless, another podium finish, man. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, let's see if we can get our winner. Hey, Nick, this is Doug in the booth. You got me?
What's up, Doug?
Hey, I have to ask, did you have somebody putting glue on your tires at certain points on the track, or?
No, just the stars align sometimes.
They definitely do. You had one of the most consistent runs, one of the most planted runs. When we were in car with you, you weren't having to fight the car up or down the mountain, as Jason Wahlberg just did a perfect jump. Wow, that's impressive.
Nice.
You were one of the few. We even watched Juho go up and down the mountain, and he was having to fight the car, but you were just so planted, it didn't even look like it fazed you.
Yeah, I got a setup that I really liked, and obviously I like this circuit. It's one of my favorites. And ton of practice this week, because I've gotten my own way so many times this season that I was determined to just, hey, let's finish the race, try and stay as consistent as I can.
Well, that definitely paid off. You were dominant, led every single lap today, and just walked away from the field. Congratulations, man.
Hey, thanks, Doug, and good job to everybody else, Juho and those guys. Anytime you can beat them, that's an accomplishment. So I don't take it lightly, and because they're good drivers.
All right, buddy. Congrats. Great job.
Thanks.
It is not often you see a car dominate the way Nick Sorensen did today, but you know what? He got it done. Big win for him. And he is the first person to win this season other than Juho and Giancarlo. Those two have split 9 wins so far. Race number 10, though, goes to Nick Sorensen. Just a few weeks left in the season. Points are really starting to add up. Things are looking really exciting for the next 2 weeks. You're not going to want to miss that. Make sure you come back tonight at 6 Eastern as the Massive Well PD event continues. 3 more races tonight and more cars qualifying for tomorrow night. You can find out more about it at xcalracing.com. There are still spots available for tonight. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Hope you had as much fun as we did, and have a great day.